In this video, we'll compare Go with Rust programming language only using standard library. In the next video, I'll cover Tokyo Runtime, which is a synchronous runtime that Rust does not officially support yet, and it's actually the foundation for most high-performance frameworks. It's actually very easy to create a production-ready Go REST application using only standard library that would handle thousands of requests per second. I don't know about you, but I learned Rust by reading the Rust book. And in the last chapter, they guide you how to build a single-threaded and then multi-threaded web server. So I took it from there for this benchmark. I use AdBS to run all my benchmarks, and for this video I used M7A large EC2 instance for each application and deployed them on VMs directly using systemd service files. Alright, let's go ahead and run the test. It took around 2 hours and I compressed it while editing to just a few minutes. You would see a single Go application and two versions of Rust with a single thread and a thread pool of 10 threads. Here we measure latency using P90 percentile from the client side. Then we have throughput, which are requests per second. We also measure CPU usage of each application as well as the overall memory usage of the entire VM. As you can see, a single-threaded Rust application could only handle 1500 requests per second. The multi-threaded version was a little bit better and reached 4000 requests per second. To find the maximum for Go, we need to run this test for one more minute, and after I'll open each graph for the entire test duration one by one. First, we have requests per second. And it's not to say that Rust is slow, it's just that synchronous model does not work well in applications if you need to wait for network operations. Even if you have multiple threads, you'll see a huge difference in the next video with the Tokyo runtime. Next, we have latency, CPU usage. And once again, you can see low CPU usage because Rust must wait for network operations to complete and wastes a lot of time. And finally, memory usage. We have some kind of spike here in memory usage when the server was overloaded with requests. So don't be upset about Rust poor performance and wait for the next video. I have other benchmarks with Postgres versus MySQL, Redis versus Memcached, and other benchmarks that you might find interesting.